Hi folks, so the questions we have here in front of us today guys are based on the chapter of Solids in Contact. It's in your workbook, DCG Solutions, page 58. Just based off the brief descriptions I gave you there guys, what we're going to be going over today is a couple little bits on the cone and the sphere. Okay, starting off with the cone guys, just a quick recap on what I was doing there inside in the little Teams meeting. What we have here is a cone, okay? In the elevation view, we can see it obviously generate, or the image is a triangle. In the plan view, we can see a circle, okay? The apex I've just labeled here, which is O, and you can see where I've labeled it down here, because that will be where the top of our cone is in the plan. I've also labeled this line here, which is known as the extreme generator, okay? So I'm just gonna write that in there, okay? Extreme generator. All right. Extreme generator. Okay, this line here, OB, would also be an extreme generator. Okay, and what's important to note from that is obviously we can see that it is a triangle in our elevation view, whereas it's a circular plan. But what's important to note is the line O, which is at the apex down to A, okay, even though that is an inclined line, it's an extreme generator in our elevation. In our plan view, we see the line OA as being parallel to the XY line, okay? And also the line OB, which is another extreme generator on the right hand side, we would see that in our plan view from here to here. So actually, this line here, if we just follow A to O to B, in our plan view, that's a straight line, okay? It is two generators that are connected at O, okay, essentially, and what they are is a straight line in our plan view, okay? But that's why, that's the image we see as we look in this direction, because we're seeing the line A to O and then from O to B. A to O, O to B. Okay? Now, in this question, what they're asking us to do, guys, is it says, show our projections of a cone. The given point is on the surface of the cone. Locate this point in plan using the generator method. Okay, so we're given this point here in our elevation view, and what we have to do is we have to find it in our plan view. Now, we know if it's here in our elevation, in plan, it has to be directly down. So if I was to transfer that down, it has to be down here somewhere. But the question is, we don't know exactly roughly where it is in here exactly, okay? I don't know, is it here, is it here, is it here, is it here, and so on. I don't know where it is along there. But what I will do starting off with is, I will just transfer that down, okay? So just transfer that information down. So for that point there, I know it's down along that line there somewhere, okay? Now the next thing I have to do is they want us to use the generator method, okay? So what I want to do is from the apex of my cone, from O, I am going to create a generator from O down through the point in elevation until it hits the XY line, okay? That there is a generator. It is not the extreme generator, because the extreme generators were out on the outside, okay? They were the edges of our cone, okay? But it's like I essentially brought that extreme generator and I rotated it across, okay? Around the cone from the about the point O, okay? And what we have is now is a generator that is running through a point that we want to find in plan. Now on that generator, I have the point O, and I've also got a point down here, which is at the base of my cone, okay? So the base of my cone, we know on the outside here in my plan view, is down here. It's the circle, it's the perimeter of the cone, okay? Or the circumference of the cone, okay? So if I transfer that down, that point there, okay, is now here in my plan view, because it has to be somewhere on the circumference. Now there is a debate obviously that it could be also here as well, but I'm just going to assume in this case that it's at the front as we're looking in at it, okay, because that point here is at the front as we see it, okay? So that's where I'm assuming that it is, okay? Not here, but here. All right, so that generator travels down, okay? So we can see that that generator in my plan view is down here. Okay, it's this one, but we have to put that generator in. Okay, now all I'm going to do is going to connect that generator up to O, because it's also connected to O in my elevation. So that generator there, that's the elevation view of it, this is the plan view of it, and where that cuts through the line where we brought the point down, that there now is our point in our plan view. Okay, very, very simple. That is the generator method. Okay, nice and easy. You could also do that working backwards. If we were given this point at the very, very start, from O, I could do a generator all the way here, connected up. then I could bring this up where it hits here, connect it up to O, and then obviously bring the point up. So you can just do it working backwards. Okay, that is finding a point on a cone using the generator method. Now, same thing over here, only we're given another point roughly in the same position, but this time it's saying show an arc of projections of a cone. The given point is on the surface of the cone. Locate this point in plan using the horizontal section method. Okay, so what they're asking us to do this time is they are asking us to basically get a cone, okay, and they want us to cut the top of it off, okay? So we all know if we cut the top of a cone off, what shape we're going to see is essentially another circle on the top of it, okay? So if I was to do a horizontal cut like that, okay, obviously I do my cut where the point is, okay? If I essentially, what I've done is I've removed this portion of the cone. Okay, now if I'm looking down on top of it, the shape I'm going to see here, even though in elevation we see it as a straight line, the shape I'm going to see here is actually another circle, only it's going to be a smaller circle than the one I have down here in plan. So what I can do is that horizontal cut, okay, this horizontal cut, just write that in, horizontal cut, has now cut my extreme generators OA and OB at two points, right here and right here. Okay, so if I was to transfer one of them down, it doesn't matter which one, in this case I'll just transfer, yeah, I'll transfer this one down. Remember now, that's on the line OB. So if we look, the line here O to B is there, therefore that's the point right here. Okay, and as I said, we have a circle when we look down on top of it because it's cutting off the top of a cone. So what we want to do now is we want to draw in that circle, and we do have the radius because the center is O. That's a point then where it's cutting on the outside, okay, on the extreme generator. So now I can actually draw in that circle as we would see it in our plan view. Okay, as you can see there, now essentially what I have done is I've cut off the top surface of the cone in my plan view, and we can see we have a flat surface here, which is another circle. Now what I also have to do is just locate where that point is on the surface, okay? We know it's on that cut surface, so it's literally just a case of, once again, transferring it down. Transfer it down, and I can see there that I have located it right here in this position. That is my point in the plan view using the horizontal cut section method. Okay, two methods there. One was the generator method, the other one was the horizontal cut section method. Both just as effective, just depends which one you find a little bit easier to do. I think this one is just a little bit quicker here, the generator method, in that it's just obviously you don't have to use your compass, it's just usually using your set square and your pencil. Okay, so but both just as effective. Okay, just being able to visualize how that works. Okay, essentially we could find any point on this horizontal cut as well. Basically, if I had another point over here, let's just say we have another point right there, if I put in another point there, you'd see once again we could just transfer that down. Okay, and that would be another point on the surface of the cone. Okay, just very quickly now, we're going to go and do another one where we're just very quickly working backwards. Okay, so just working backwards there now. In this one, in part number 3, you can see it says, show an arc of projections of a cone. The given point is on the surface of the cone. Locate the point in elevation. So this one is just working backwards. We've now got a point in our plan view. Okay, it looks obviously close enough to where it was over here as well. We have a point in the plan view and we want to find it in the elevation. And I will just do on this one, I'll do the two methods just so we can see it working backwards. So using the generator method, okay, I'm going to go from the apex of the cone in my plan view through the point to where it cuts the circumference of the base of the cone. Where it cuts the circumference of the base of the cone, transfer it up to my elevation, where it is in my elevation, put in that generator and elevation. Okay, and then somewhere along that generator is going to be my point. Locate the point in plan, project it up. Very, very simple. Okay, and there is our point in our elevation. That's using the generator method. Another one I could use, I was just explaining, was the horizontal cut method. So a horizontal cut, only this time I have the radius in plan because I know where the point is. So what I'll do is I'll put in the horizontal cut, which will be seen as a circle. There's my circle, there's my cut. And for the sake of it, I will bring it up here. So the outside point where it cuts the generator, the extreme generator OB, check that up. And pretty close there. And there's our horizontal cut, okay? Just based on my accuracy, I'm using biros here, it's a bit out, but you get the idea, okay? So that's the horizontal cut. And then this one was the generator. Okay, hope you found those easy enough, guys. At this point, you can tip away with them, and then we'll get on to the sphere. So I'm just going to pause. You can pause the video there. Right, lads. So the next part of the problems here on this question have to do with the sphere. Okay, so we can see here with two problems in front of us, okay, both spheres, and what we have is we have a point in elevation on this one, and in this one we have a point in our plan, okay, and what we have to do is we have to locate where that point is down in our plan view, and on this one locate where this point is in our elevation view, okay. And for a sphere, we cannot run any straight lines because obviously a sphere is a curved surface, okay. So what we're going to use is horizontal cuts method, okay. And we're going to apply the principle that we've just previously done on the cone, and we're going to use that here as well on the sphere, okay. So it says, question 4, show an arc of projections of a sphere. The given point is on the surface of the sphere. Locate this point in plan. Now, when you're doing a horizontal cut section, when you do the horizontal cut through the point in our elevation view, okay, our horizontal cut is always going to be a straight line that is parallel to the xy line, okay? And where that cuts the sphere, it's going to cut at two points, right here and right here, okay? And kind of like in the cone, that is going to be almost where it runs across our extreme generators, even though in this case it's not really generators, but where it cuts across this line, this axis line here, okay? So once I project those points down, because that's where they're going to cut on the, another image that we're going to have is we're going to have another circle that's cutting on the top of this, because as we cut off the top of that sphere, if I put my hand just over it there, essentially this line here, the horizontal cut line, that's going to generate another circle on the top of the sphere. Okay, so I'll just write that in, horizontal cut. In the little spaces down here, you can do a sketches for your own understanding, okay? Anyway, that point, I'm after projecting it down, project it down here, okay? Because as I said, that's kind of like our axis line that's running across it, because as we look down top of it, we'd see that line there, this circumference line here, would be seen like this straight line in our plan. And now what I want to do is I want to put in that cut surface, which we would see in plan view as another circle, just a smaller one. Put in that circle there. And if I was to project this point down, there we go. That is where my point is in the plan view. Okay? That is how you would get a point on a sphere in your plan view using the horizontal cut section method. Okay? Now, on this question, we're going to do the exact same thing, only we're working backwards. Okay? So in our plan view, we have the radius. So it's literally a case of from the center of our circle in plan out to the point, put in your horizontal cut, which we would obviously is a circle. Where it hits here, I'm going to project that up. Okay, I want to assume that it was at the top of the sphere as it was cutting. Here is my horizontal cut once again. Now I don't need to do the line beyond it, as you can see there, obviously it's only going from here to here. I'm just showing you essentially it's what it is a plane that is cutting across it, Okay, it's like taking a sheet of paper and slicing through it. Okay, so that's my horizontal cut section there, and the point is right down here in my plan view. So very, very simple. Check that up. And we have now located that in our elevation as well. There's the point in our elevation view. Okay, so just get those done there. Once again, you can pause the video at this point. Okay. Right, folks, last question on this page here. And so far we have done the cone and the sphere. And now what we're moving on to is the cylinder. Okay, so it says, question 6, shown are the projections of a cylinder. The given point is on the surface of the cylinder, front side, locate this point in plan. Okay, so we can see here we've got the elevation up here, plan view down here. Anytime you look at a cylinder, okay, you are going to see a rectangle. Okay, or depending on the height of it, you could possibly see a square. But in this case, we have a rectangle. Now, this cylinder, obviously, we can see is, might hardly be wide, but chances are I'm guessing it's on its side. So if I was just to zoom out there, just for a second, and if we were to take a cylinder, so just took something we have in our households, say a salt or something like that, okay. What we're assuming is when we look at the elevation of a cylinder, that's roughly kind of what you're going to see there. Okay, you're going to see a rectangle where the height of it is from here down to here, and then obviously the width from here to here. Okay, and in this case what you're telling us is our cylinder is kind of sideways like that. Okay, so in the elevation view you'd see that, and then the plan view, obviously looking down the bird's eye view, you'd also see this as well. Elevation, kind of you're looking straight in at it in the direction of my finger here, plan view looking down on top of it. Now what we have is essentially they're saying we have a point on it. Okay, which we can see here, and it's saying it's at the front side. Okay, so essentially what they're saying is that point, roughly it's up high, it's on the front side, it's probably somewhere in there like that. Okay, so as I'm looking straight at it, I can see it from the front. That's what they're basically saying to me. It's not over here somewhere at the back. Okay, and the thing is with a cylinder, you can only see where that point is roughly when you look at it from the end view here in this case. Okay, because a cylinder, when you look at it from the end view, what you're actually going to see is, if I bring that end view up to you, you're going to see a circle. Now I know in this view currently, as you're looking down it on the camera, you're seeing kind of the plan view technically, okay? But the end view, when the cylinder is on the side, is we see the circle in this case, okay? So what we have to do is we actually have to do the end view as a circle, because we essentially, that point which we can see here, is along the perimeter or the circumference of that circle, okay? So what we're going to do, I'll just zoom back in there now, is we're going to project an end elevation. Okay, so end elevation, okay, I'm going to project it out here. So pin that out, and center of my sphere is somewhere out there. Okay, and from the corner of my elevation, project down to 45 degrees. I need the centers because we know it's a circle, so my center is there. And the two centers will meet up right here at this point here. Okay. Right there. Now what I can do is I can draw in the end elevation. Okay. We know it's lying flat in the ground, so it's that distance there. Rotate it around. And there you go. That is the end view of my cylinder. Okay, what I will actually do there, just very quickly, I'm gonna put that in a bit dark. No, I'll leave it the way it is, it's absolutely fine. All right, that's the end elevation of my cylinder. Okay, now what we have to do is we have to locate this point down here, but we'll actually end up finding it in all three views, but the exact position, and it said it was down at the front. Okay, so first of all, if it's there in elevation, it has to be directly below it in the plan. It told us that it was down here on this side, okay, because it was at the front of it as we looked at it. So technically, if it's down here, if let's say it was here, okay, and I followed this over, technically it means it has to be probably over here somewhere, okay. So using simple orthographic projection, projected across, and this is what I was saying, did we know it was here or here? Well, we know it's this one, because if we follow that down and bring it across, it told us it was at the front of it, okay. So what I'm going to do is at this point here, project it down, cuts there, project it across, and very, very simple. That is my point in my plan view, and technically I've already found it also here in my end elevation. Okay, that is how you would locate a point on your cylinder using orthographic projection, guys. Okay, we have to see the end view of it to be able to get it though. Okay, so at this point there, guys, you can go off and do that question now. Hope you found that useful.